There may be some in this auditorium. There may be some here today that will be homosexual in the future. There are a lot of kids here. There may be some girls that'll turn lesbian. We don't know. But it's serious. Don't kid yourselves about it. They can be anywhere. They can be judges, lawyers. We ought to know. We've arrested all of them. So if any one of you have let yourself become involved with an adult homosexual or with another boy, and you're doing this on a regular basis, you better stop quick. Because one out of three of you will turn queer. And if we catch you involved with a homosexual, your parents are going to know about it first. And you will be caught. Don't think you won't be caught. Because this is one thing you cannot get away with.
In our present-day society, gay rights are existent and present in the world today. But in the 1950s, things were not as free as they seemed. They were forced to be the perfect image of the 1950s, non-communists, living the American dream, etc. Before the 1950s, gay individuals met up on their own time to meet each other and created their own sort of identity. By 1915, there were participants that began to foster a more organized community. It was mostly hidden from view due to the mindset of its current society, but the urban gay culture began to become more known. During World War II, even young people who left to fight in the war ended up making choices to support their gay identities. Countless of them revolved around bars and creative friendships, and there are other people like them.
Concern about homosexuals in society, about their increasing visibility. In preparing this broadcast, CBS News commissioned a survey by the Opinion Research Corporation into public attitudes toward homosexuality.
Many LGBT people who had yet to publicly identify themselves as homosexual became workers in the Black Civil Rights Campaign that began in the 1950s. By the following decade, the influence of the civil rights movement was making itself known within the homophile movement. There is the Mattachine Society and a similarly conservative lesbian group called the Daughters of Bilitis, or DOB. In the early 1950s, the homophile movement broke out. The movement included demanding equal rights for gender and sexual orientation. At this point in time, gay people were frowned upon as the movement countered McCarthy's. Soon, even the FBI had begun surveillance programs against homosexuals in what was known as the Lavender Scare. Thousands and thousands of federal employees lost their jobs. The government used numerous tactics to identify homosexuals and took audiences inside interrogation rooms where gay men and women were subjected to questioning.
While the term transgender was not yet in use during the 50s, the idea of someone assigned one gender at birth and then medically transitioning to the opposite gender drew national attention in 1952. Christine Jorgensen, the first national transgender celebrity, underwent surgery and hormone treatments in Denmark in 1952 to change from a male to a female.
During the year of 1964, we arrested 3,000 homosexuals who committed their lewd acts in public places. I can state conclusively that the problem is growing. I'm concerned with the moral atmosphere in the community, and I'm opposed, as a matter of principle, to making anything which is improper or immoral conspicuous.
LGBT people had been making themselves visible and organizing politically for nearly two decades. When early gay and lesbian rights organizations began, the country was in the midst of one of the most conservative periods in the 20th century. People claimed that they were security risks who were vulnerable to Soviet blackmail. Alfred Kinsey, a sexologist who founded the Institute for Sex Research at Indiana University during the late 1940s, had released two books, one of them being Sexual Behavior in the Human Male, and the other being Sexual Behavior in the Human Female. They both shocked and motivated others into forming the first gay secret society called the Mattachine Society, which was run by Henry Hay.
During this era, police harassment of gays was very common. In fact, police forces would go as far as threatening to revoke liquor licenses of bars if they committed cross-dressing or same-sex dancing, which caused many homosexuals to come out and protest.
In the 1960s, there was a gay movement that absorbed the successive influences of the civil rights, but it took several years for these movements to converge and for a gay community to actually adopt a civil rights agenda and burst into American politics. The development of gay rights was foreshadowed in 1960 by two events. First, there was a proposal as the subject of its annual conference in the drafting of the Homosexual Bill of Rights. The proposal drew criticism from the Madison Society and Daughters of Bilitis. These groups felt that such a document took a demanding attitude towards society.
The second event in 1959 was when a mayor in San Francisco was running for re-election. In move to gain support, the opposing candidate accused the mayor of harboring sexual deviants within the city. Throughout the early 60s, San Francisco remained a center of gay activism. Police extortion of gay bars became a scandal in 1961, when several bars refused to pay and went to court instead. While public displays of affection by same-sex couples are commonplace today, the fact that this picture was taken in 1953, a time when LGBT people could be arrested for simply holding hands with someone of the same sex, makes it a powerful and beautiful image demonstrating the spirit of LGBT pride. Take a look at the two images of the young men freely showing their affection for one another in the privacy of a photo booth at the 1953 PGE exhibition at Hastings Park in Vancouver, Canada.
The MRG, Minorities Research Group, was formed in 1964, and they provided isolated lesbians with resources and information about female homosexuality and the opportunity to meet other women. Men had roundabout ways of finding places to go.
Stonewall riots, a major factor in this movement, were a series of violent demonstrations by members of the gay LGBT community against the police raid that took place in the early morning hours of June 28, 1969, at the Stonewall Inn, located in the Greenwich Village neighborhood of Manhattan, New York City. The crowd on the street watched quietly as Stonewall's employees were arrested, but when three drag queens and a lesbian were forced into the paddy wagon, the crowd began throwing bottles at the police. The Stonewall riot was followed by several days of demonstrations in New York and was famous for the formation of the Gay Liberation Front, as well as other gay, lesbian, and bisexual civil rights organizations. The riots inspired LGBT people throughout the country to organize in support of gay rights, and within 2 years after the riots, gay rights groups had been started in nearly every major city in the United States.
Storm De La Vera was a known leader during Stonewall. She was known as the butch lesbian that threw the first punch towards the police. Witness saw her as a cross-dressing lesbian who was yelling, "Why don't you guys do something?" which got a reaction from the bystanders that made the riot a defining moment in history.
Marsha P. Johnson was one of the leaders of the Stonewall riots. According to some witnesses, Johnson was the one who started it, screaming and throwing rocks and most likely Molly Pitcher in the revolution. She dedicated her life to activism. Until the passing of the Sexual Offenses Bill in 1967, male homosexual activity was illegal. Gay men were imprisoned for consensual sex with another man. Lesbianism was not illegal, but was similarly subject to public disapproval, or ignored. Despite the dangers and difficulties involved, gay men and women were able to find places to meet. It was not until 1973 that the American Psychiatric Association removed homosexuality as an illness classification into its diagnostic manuals. Throughout the 1950s and 60s, gay men and lesbians were at risk for psychiatric lockup and jail for losing jobs or child custody in courts. Clinics were defining gay love as sick, immoral, and even criminal.
In 1972, the first gay minister was ordained by the United Church of Christ. Other gay and lesbian church and synagogue congregations soon followed. Also, Parents and Friends of Lesbians and Gays, or known as PFLAG, which was formed in 1972, offered family members greater support roles in the gay rights movement. In 1979, the first march on Washington for gay rights had occurred.
It was an era in which the New York Times used the words homosexual and pervert interchangeably, and public service films warned that homosexuality was a dangerous, contagious disease. Instead of destroying American homosexuals, the actions of the government had the opposite effect. They stirred a sense of outrage and activism that helped ignite the gay rights movement.
Gaining LGBT rights during this era was a major struggle for those who wished to love people that were the same gender as them. This movement completely awakened people to the facts of LGBT rights and were able to create new laws. This movement was also a crucial factor to the gay marriage laws that are present today. It was a matter of utmost importance that opened eyes for America and made people more accepting towards it. It was not a complete success, but people were more free to express who they were. The Stonewall riots and the Lavender Scare were key factors before this movement, but it is still an ongoing issue today. Although same-sex marriage is now legal, gay and lesbian couples are still being discriminated against.